Hello, welcome to the Monday, June 21st, 2021 edition of the Sand Centered Storm Centers Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Got a couple of nice diaries this weekend. First of all, Daniel wrote the second part of his network forensics on Azure VMs diary. The second part covers Azure Monitor Insights, which actually allows you to combine and link network traffic to processes running within the virtual machine. That's actually a quite common problem where you're trying to figure out which particular process is responsible for particular network traffic. In a second diary on Friday, Daniel wrote about two open redirects within Google's ecosystem that are currently actively being exploited for phishing. First one, meet.google.com, and the second one, hangouts.google.com. These two URLs can be used to redirect an unsuspecting victim to any website. Of course, when they're clicking on the link, they'll see the Google URL and likely trust it, for example, with their Google credentials. And because these URLs are so popular, it's really hard kind of to rein them in and to, for example, block them or filter for them in emails, because yes, they're sadly also used legitimately. Never wondered for a good set of non-malicious software hashes? Well, that always existed. The reference data set published by NIST. Access to it hasn't been difficult, but usually a bit awkward. You had to download entire ISO files with these hashes. Circle, the Luxembourg cert, is now making these hashes available as a DNS service, so that should make it a lot easier to look them up. You can also look them up via a simple HTTP service. What you'll find in the dataset is, for example, binaries that ship by default with Windows and the like. NIST is known for being quite careful in what they're adding to this list, so this can help you to essentially eliminate certain binaries if you, for example, do a forensics investigation or if you have a suspect binary, for example, delivered as an attachment or such. It will make it pretty easy to figure out that this is not malicious if it's a part of the normal operating system distribution. And if you own an iOS device, you should be a little bit careful as to what Wi-Fi SSIDs you connect to. There's currently an unpatched vulnerability in iOS that will shut down and disable Wi-Fi functionality if you are connecting to a specific SSID, and that SSID is %P%S%S%S%S%N. Well, probably not very inviting, that SSID, for most users, but if you are familiar with development, you probably noticed that this is a format string, and apparently what's happening here is that the SSID is concatenated with a format string that leads to a denial of service condition. The somewhat annoying part here is that just rebooting your phone or connecting to a different SSID will not fix the problem. You will have to reset your network settings. And in the show notes, I'll link to an analysis of this vulnerability. And according to this analysis, the only possible exploit here is the denial of service. Sometimes format string vulnerabilities like this are also exploitable for code execution, but this does not appear to be the case here. And the National Security Agency, NSA, has published a cybersecurity technical report, as they call it, about how to deploy secure unified communications, voice and video over IP systems. Voice over IP and video over IP security, of course, is always a big topic, and these NSA guys are well respected. The 40 pages of the guide are going over pretty much all of the aspects of voice over IP security, including sort of some of the underlying network technologies, like, for example, DHCP and such, in order to deploy these systems, or also gateways to a good old standard phone services. The guide itself is not vendor specific, but what you'll often see is where vendors will adopt these guides and then publish their own guides that will tell you how to implement these different recommendations in a particular vendor's system. Well, and that's it for today. Thanks for listening. Remember, we are also available via Amazon's Alexa smart speakers as one of their flash briefing sources. If you like this podcast, please let your friends know about it. And that's it for today. And talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.